Welcome back to Bloomberg News. Stephen Begleiter took sixth place at the World Series of Poker earlier this month. A former head of corporate strategy at Bear Stearns earned $1.6 million in his second time playing the $10 million buy-in event. What's next for him? Steve is now a senior principal at FlexPoint Ford, a private equity firm. He joins us now with more. Steve, welcome to Bloomberg News. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks very much for having me, guys.
You can't make this up, can you?
No, it's sort of a dream come true.
This is an interesting story. Tell us about your interest in poker after spending 24 years at one company.
Well, you know, I'm a casual social poker player and played poker most of my life with friends for very small stakes. When Hold'em got popular, we formed a league.
You always this good?
I think I was pretty good for the guys I played against. I didn't think I could go sit there, go toe-to-toe with Phil Ivey.
Yeah, really?
You know, that's the great thing about this main event is it allows humble amateurs and the top pros to go, side by side. And they can't use their big money skills to pressure you out because the buy-in caps how much you can lose.
Right.
So talk about your experience in the World Series of Poker. You placed out sixth. I don't know anything, my disclaimer about poker, so forgive me.
Yes.
But from what I hear, it was a pretty dramatic out.
Sure. So real quick, there are almost 6,500 entrants this year. Mm-hmm. In July, we played from 6,500 to 9. I was lucky to be one of those 9. That was a big accomplishment. And then they bring the final 9 back to play in November. And that just happened recently. And I was doing pretty well. I was holding my own. I got all my chips in with the best cards. I had 2 queens. A guy named Darvin Moon had ace queen. He had more chips than me. There's 5 cards to come.
Yeah.
Four of them were safe, and the last, very last one was an ace, which knocked me out. I was a 93% favorite at that point, but I couldn't dodge that one last bit of bad luck.
So is it a disappointment to you, or do you just chalk it up to you never know what's going to happen? It's
well,
poker
there's certain,
after all.
You know, getting a random draw of bad cards is certainly part of the game. What happened to me happened to a lot of other people early in the tournament, so I was very lucky to get there. I'd be lying to say I'm not a little disappointed about how that hand played out and one other hand played out that I didn't do so well on.
But you still took home a pretty penny, and especially for the partners that you bought in with, correct?
Oh, yeah, yeah. 20% gets shared with the people who are in the game where I won my entry fee, and it was just a great thrill. Everybody had a great time.
So now you're at this private equity fund. How do you balance your time now? Are you still, do you practice for poker? I'm sorry, again, I don't know anything about.
Yeah, so, when I made the final table in July, my partners were very good in allowing me to have the time I needed to play a little bit more poker. I went to some tournaments, things I wouldn't normally do.
Yeah.
But now that that's over, I'm probably back to being a one tournament a year guy.
Can you talk to me about the psychology of that as relates to what you were doing on Wall Street, your career on Wall Street? Are there some parallels to be drawn here?
Yeah, people ask me that. There are definitely some. You need to have an affinity for, at least the way I play, understanding your probabilities pretty quickly. But really, your opponents, especially your high-caliber opponents, they're telling you stories, and you're trying to tell stories.
Yeah.
And you either got to believe them or not. And I think a lot of us in the investment business, we hear a lot of stories, and we make judgments on whether we believe them or not. We put our chips to work in one way or the other. And I've been doing that for a long time, and I think... at the poker table, it's very heightened. It's a very quick knowledge.
So I guess what I'm asking is, would you suggest that your strategic thinking on Wall Street was actually a plus for you and maybe gave you an advantage?
I think listening to a lot of people pitch their stories and figuring out what's real and what isn't.
And being able to tune that out and still concentrate on what you have to do.
Guys, Bloomberg actually had a story on the terminal this morning about a Harvard University professor, Department of Economics, saying that some of the best candidates for Wall Street trading jobs are professional card players. So there you go. Point made.
Listen, I got to meet, it's a young man's game. I got to meet a lot of young people in their 20s who are very good card players that, were we still at Bear Stearns, I would have tried to get him to come join the firm. Okay,
wow.
They're very talented people. One of them coached me, John Little, who's 24, very accomplished player. People like him would do very well here on Wall Street.
What was your experience with Bear Stearns? Were you there in the collapse?
Yeah, I was there. It was my only job. I started right out of college, and I was there till the day we closed on the deal with J.P. Morgan. And I had a pretty good seat on what was happening. It was really my second family, so it was a great disappointment the way things ended.
All right, so we have a deck of cards here.
Mm-hmm.
You want to play a hand?
As long as you don't give me 2 queens, okay?
I'll let you deal.
You know what? Right before you go, on the way you went out, mm-hmm. is that one of those things where you go into the bathroom, you start slamming the stall doors?
Now we know how you get your frustrations.
Yeah, my frustrations.
Yeah, you're a 93% favorite, and basically, if I win that pot, I'm in a 3-way tie for the lead with 6 guys left, and that's a great spot to be in. But it's part of the game. I was
Let's
conditioned.
Let's see your best poker face. We have the ISO shot of you up right now.
I need my red hat and my sunglasses. Okay. But basically, your face gives away all your tells, so you want to cover up as much of it as possible.
Oh, that's a good tip. Okay. That's a first tip today. All right, yeah. Do you play electronic poker as well?
I never really played until I made the final table. I got sponsored by Full Tilt. I started playing some.
Wow.
There are elements of it that are good to practice.
Awesome. Good stuff,
Steven. Steve Begleiter.